Oh dear students, today I will start with my next video, which is based on a carbon microphone, which comes under audio systems in applications of electronic engineers. So the heading will be carbon microphone. Now we know that microphone is a transducer. Microphone is a electroacoustic transducer. Okay, now it will convert sound waves into electrical waves. Okay, so its main work is to convert sound energy into electrical energy. Now in this carbon microphone we are going to use basic resistance of carbon granules. Okay, now in this figure we have shown that the sound waves are incident here, and here you are having a diaphragm. Okay, and here you are having a fixed electrode, and in between you are having all this carbon granules, and when the sound hits or incident on the diaphragm, it will move in and out, and hence the movement of carbon granules will be either they are pressed or unpressed. Okay, so in that case the resistance of carbon granules will vary. Now that resistance we have to use with a external DC bias like this and make a formation of current flow. So as the resistance of the carbon granules vary, the current will also vary, and that variation in current will be the representation of sound. Now the same thing we will show with a clear diagram. Now here we can see you are having your sound waves which are incident. So here you can see your sound pressure coming. Now this sound pressure is going to come and hit the diaphragm. Okay, now this diaphragm is connected to a electrode. This is one electrode and this is another electrode. So this electrode is a fixed electrode, whereas this electrode is a movable carbon electrode. And in this chamber you will be having all these carbon granules. These are all carbon granules as mentioned here. These are all carbon granules. Now the diaphragm is connected to this movable electrode with the help of mica and silk washers. Okay, now when the sound wave is incident on the diaphragm, when the sound waves strikes the diaphragm from here, so sound wave strikes the diaphragm, there is a mechanical movement of the diaphragm. This diaphragm is going to move, and that movement will move this electrode also. Now this electrode will move the position of the granules inside. Now here a granule position will be pressed or unpressed. There will be a movement with the granules or carbon granules, because of which the resistance of the carbon granules will vary. Okay, now this variation in resistance, if we want to convert into some electrical quantity, then we have to connect a external DC bias over here. So here if you connect the external DC bias as shown, the voltage E here. So here you can see this is minus plus, this is your external DC bias. Now this is a circuit which will be connected to the movable electrode, and it will be connected with some resistance, and it will be connected to the fixed electrode. Okay, so this circuit is complete, and because it is complete there will be a flow of current. Okay, there will be a flow of current, say I. Okay, now as the sound is incident on the diaphragm vibrates. This will vibrate the movable electrode, this will change the positions of the granules inside, and because of which the resistance of the granules will vary, and variation in a resistance in this circuit will vary this flow of current, which is because of the DC bias attached here. So this variation in current, whatever you get here, will be a representation of the sound waves. Hence we can say sound energy is converted into electrical energy. Now this is how your carbon microphone is going to work. So if you see the note on that, the basic concept behind the carbon microphone is the fact that when a carbon granules are compressed, their resistance decreases. This is what specifically happens. When they are compressed, their resistance decreases. This occurs because the granules come into better contact with each other when they are pushed together by the high pressure. The carbon microphone comprises carbon granules that are contained within a small container that is covered with a thin metal diaphragm. A battery is also required to cause a current to flow through the microphone. When sound waves strike the carbon microphone diaphragm, it vibrates. This is what we have seen, exerting a varying pressure onto the carbon granules. This varying pressure are translated into varying levels of resistance, which in turn vary the current passing through the microphone. So the variation in current will represent the variation of sound. Hence we can say sound energy is converted into electrical energy. So the advantages of carbon microphones are, it is having first advantage as high output. Second advantage, you can have simple principle and construction as we have seen. And third advantage is it is cheap and simple to manufacture. If you see the disadvantages, then it is very noisy, high background noise, and on occasions it would crackle. It has poor frequency response and it requires battery or other supply for the operation, because you have to make the current to flow at the outer circuit, and that a current representation is going to represent your sound waves. Now in that case you require an external battery. That is the disadvantage of it. Now if you go to see the applications, the most important applications were the telephony systems. In our telephones in earlier days, when we had this type of telephones as shown in the picture, we had a cup on the hearing side and a cup on a speaking side. So the cup which is there on the speaking side consists of carbon microphone. So they were widely used in our telephone applications because they gave a high output, which meant no amplification was used. Okay, so this was the most important usage of carbon microphones. Thank you, students.